As a follow-up to the meeting between the Senate Committee on Customs and the Comptroller General of a Nigerian Customs Service, we had a chat with the chairman of the committee, Senator Hope Uzodinma, to learn more about the Customs Amendment Act.
We are taking a holistic look at the entire act. Reason being that the act was enacted in 1958. If you look at the way businesses were done in 1958 and the new realities of the current century, a lot of things has changed. The customs service itself should be able to look like the customs service outside this climate. The way trade is being executed in Nigeria should also be modified. So from every facet of life, trade facilitation, revenue generation, the discipline of the officers of the service, the strength of the service, and their potentials towards competing with the similar services in other climes, there is a need for a reform. There is a need for a comprehensive overhaul. And the foundation to that is the law. The act that established the service is key. So we want to start the change. We want to start it from foundation. By first of all, amending the act to be able to capture new realities in international business.
Now, one of the things which your committee has been talking about in the last few months is improving the revenue generating, you know, capability of the Nigerian Customs Service. What specifically are you doing or is your committee doing to meet this objective?
How do you explain the situation? Yes, the economy is not good. The economy is, we are in recession. The quantum of trade has come down. But to what extent, to what ratio? I discussed with the National Bureau of Statistics. The decline in trade is below 20%. Decline in customs revenue is above 50%. How do you reconcile that? The customs service that will now fall in 1994, they collected 917 billion. In 2014, they collected 917 billion. In 2015, they collected 917 billion. In 2016, they are collecting below 500 billion. Then in VAT, which represents 5% of total money collected, they are collecting very close to 300 billion. If you do the arithmetic, what 5% represents as 300 billion and what 95% represents as 300 billion? You will be talking of trillions. But the question is, where is the money? Because the same people paying duty are the same people paying VAT. Yes, some of the items are not dutiable, but what percentage? Maybe waivers and that, which represent less than 15% of total imports. So we need to bring prudence. We need to bring discipline. We need to bring training. We need to bring professionalism. Customs service is a highly technical service. And only those who are technically eligible should really man customs service.
Now, a few days ago, the Nigerian Customs Service intercepted 661 pump-action rifles coming from China through the Apapa port. How did this happen, and is your committee investigating this incident?
I want to commend, first of all, Nigerian Customs Service for that action. But the question is that the only contraband that is coming into the country? Why commending them and still charging them that they can do more? The latest drain pipe to government revenue is the abuse of the use of free trade zones, where foreigners, Indians, hide under the guise of free trade zones and bring in contrabands into the country. and sell contrabands against the rule that the things manufactured are produced under within this export processing zones must be exported out of the country. But yet these things find them, their way into Nigerian markets, causing unemployment, winding up factories in Nigeria, not even listening to Export Promotion Council, so abuse of rule of origin, and so many other things. So I think that we must equip Nigerian Customs Service to be able to do their job. We must protect our borders. We must install the necessary technologies like scanners at the various ports of entries to be able to really checkmate and know when contrabands are coming to Nigeria, even goods are coming to Nigeria, knowing the quality and quantity.
Now, this is where we draw the curtain. It's on this week's edition of The Gavel. If you have any views on any of the issues discussed, please email us on thegavel@channelstv.com. Thank you for staying with us and see you again next week.